All right, good morning, everybody. Welcome to Diamond Zone Wednesday morning edition. Hopefully everybody had a great day yesterday, and we're going to get right into our information, starting with, don't forget today, guys, and support Grand Diamonds, John and Anna Marie Stroh. They will be doing the call tonight at 6 o'clock. And remember, on Wednesdays, we also do a 12 o'clock that I will be conducting really morally, mainly for the people in Europe. But obviously, it's a presentation. So if you have people that could get on at 12, okay, in the United States or wherever they live, okay, we promote that. But obviously, tonight, you want to promote very, very big as the next big event. John and Anna Marie Stroh. So they do an unbelievable presentation. So get your guest on that call. It will be very, very, very good. All right, next. What do I have? 12 o'clock and 6 o'clock today. And I guess also, Chanatita's back office, which is cnworldgn.com. There's the new presentation. If you guys want to download it, you want to make sure you download that. It'll be there for you guys to practice with. Just different slides, always being updated. So just please make sure, guys, if you guys are doing presentations, you go into their back office and you can see that. All right, so can you see my screen, SMART goals? Joe, okay, perfect. All right. So what I want to talk about today, okay, is really, you know, we're coming up on the new year, and, you know, you always reflect back on the things that you did well and the things that, you know, you could have worked on and got better at. And, you know, I always like people to reflect back from the time they made their decision, okay, to get involved with World Global Network, okay, whatever that was, because you know you have two dates, right? The day you signed and the day you actually started doing it. So from the time you started doing it, okay, you need to really reflect back what you did well and what you need to work on. Because in order for you to get better every single day, right, you got to work on what? Your weaknesses. There was a saying that I always remembered, your strengths will kill you. Your strengths will kill you because you normally live in your strengths, right? But it's the weaknesses, right? Let's talk about some of the weaknesses that I know a lot of people fail in, okay? And the only reason I know is because I've been doing this for a long period of time, and I know what I failed in. And the number one weakness a lot of people have is follow-up. Okay, follow up on initially, sometimes we're really good at just getting the initial information out, but sometimes we're afraid of the answer. We're afraid of bothering people, right? So follow up sometimes for a lot of people is usually the one correction they have to make to start getting better results, right? And you all know, based on some of the trainings we've done, if you set up the follow up, right, it makes it less stressful for you to actually make that call because they're expecting your call. Okay, so follow up, whatever it may be, maybe it's not enough people in your funnel, but you have to identify whatever that is that you have to work on. Because until we could figure that out, it's gonna be really hard to set your SMART goals for 2018. And I want to get people prepared because it's not about waiting for 2018, right, to set your goals, because you've already wasted then usually a month. It's doing it today and then working through and up to January and through 2018, which will normally allow you to achieve your goals. So just a couple of things to remember, and these are proven numbers. 2% of people. 2% of people actually set their goals. 2%. Isn't that amazing? And then you start to look at the statistics, where only 2% are going to be able to retire without having to rely on family, friends, church, or the government, or have to go back and get another job? Because these are your numbers. You should know your numbers. And it's so funny how they both interchange. Okay, 75% of people in the United States of America have to rely on family, friends, church, or the government in retirement. These are people age 65 years and older. 23% have to go back and get another job. They got to work in their retirement to supplement their income. We'll add that up. 75 plus 23 is 98. 2% are okay. 2% can maintain their standard of living, okay, or they're wealthy. 2%. Well, what does the 2% have in common? Well, there's two things. Number one, they all had a residual income stream, some type of residual income, usually multiple streams of residual income. And they had a plan and they set SMART goals in order to achieve it. 2% of people set a goal. Isn't that amazing? You would think it would be a lot higher. Okay. But what I want to get people really geared up and geared towards, okay, and get you working towards it today, is your goal a SMART goal, okay? Because you could set a goal, but is it realistic? Is it SMART? Two different things. A SMART resolution is not a basic statement or wish. It is a clear, drawn pathway to success. And a way to state not just what you want, but what you will do to accomplish it. Okay? So normally someone says, oh, I've set a goal. I want this. I want to lose 50 pounds this year. I'm going to eat better. I'm going to achieve diamond. Right? I'm going to talk to, 50 people next month. Okay? Those are just stated goals. Stated goals. There's no clear-cut plan to achieve it. Because every time you set a goal, you got to reverse engineer that goal into action steps, correct? Right? I could join the gym. I've taken the step because unless I have the membership card, then I don't even have an opportunity to walk in the door. But then I have to take that right membership card, and not only do I have to pay for it every month, I have to actually go into the gym, right? So now watch this. I walk into the gym, and now I have to make the effort to actually do the exercise. And it's not just going through the motions. I don't know, you guys, I use a lot of gym analogies because I go every day. And I know maybe some of you have been to a gym. Have you ever watched people work out? Some people just go through the motions of working out and they never even crack a sweat. Other people have a direct purpose. Oh, here we go again. Unstable. Other people have, can you hear me now, Joe? Yes, okay. Other people that walk in the gym, they have a direct purpose and they work out with a vengeance. They know exactly what they have to do. They have a certain amount of time to get it done and they get the hell out of there. That's somebody driven to achieve their results. I know there's certain times I go to the gym, I just kind of walk around. Because I'm just not in the mode. I have to get in my mind in the mode of working out. Well, it's the same thing over here. It's the same thing. And I don't care what goal I set for myself. If I was 100 pounds overweight and I worked out every now and again, I would never lose the weight. It's got to be something that drives you. It's got to be something that excites you. We talked about this yesterday. Right? Finding that inner motivation that's going to make you do something. So when you say SMART goals, S-M-A-R-T, okay? Now, let's talk about it. The S, specific. Specific, clearly define your goal. Make it as specific as possible and write down exactly why you want to achieve this goal. Okay, now, we could cut this many different ways, guys, but I want you to be clear about it. Is it a rank? Is it a dollar amount? We're talking about now, obviously, world, right now. Okay, I want to get you focused here. Is it your ranking? Is it a dollar amount? Okay, what is it you want to accomplish? And you have to write it down. You got to be clear about this. And here's, and I guess we'll talk about measurable too. But here's the other thing. When you're specific, and I'll touch on this again later, but when you're specific, you got to have a realistic goal. Let me help you with this. If you have yet to pick up a phone and make an initial call, okay, I'm telling you to have a goal of getting to president is unrealistic. Let me help you here. You might have to be very specific about, okay, today I'm going to be very specific that I'm going to have my goal to talk to 20 people first. I got to first get good at maybe my script, right? Maybe I have to get good at what text message am I going to send. Maybe I got to be specific in writing down my list. Everybody has baby goals. Okay, here's the analogy. If Jeff walked into a gym, okay, I don't have to go through the basics, guys. I've been in gyms for 25 years. I know exactly what I would have to do. So I'm going to catch up because I have experience in that gym. Some of you don't have experience in network marketing. Some of you do. And some of you have to take the baby steps, right? You have to get good at presentations. You got to get good at writing your list. You got to get comfortable on the phone. You got to get comfortable in talking to people. You got to be comfortable in your follow-up. This is how you become clear. And guys, there's nobody watching over you. In other words, you have to play your ball. You got to get good at, and if every week you're getting better at something, you watch what happens by the end of the first quarter of next year. But if you're brand new and you've yet to pick up the phone, and now your goal is to become president by the time you leave, go to Los Angeles for the conference, you're setting yourself up for failure because it's not going to happen. I hate that. And because you know why? It sounded good. I stated it. I'm going to be a president. No, you're not. No, you're not. And I'm not being mean here, but if you've never picked up a phone or done a presentation by yourself, you're not going to become a president. But can you get really good at getting the information out? Can you get good at reaching 50 people in your first week? Yes. Can I get to team developer? Absolutely. You got to set your bite-sized goals. Stop sometimes also comparing yourself to everybody else. Play your ball. Play your ball. But you got to have the ball in play. Some of your ball is not even in play. You're not even at the golf course. Right? You know what I mean? You don't even have any clubs in your bag. You're involved. You joined. Right? You're present. But see, this is what I'm talking about, being specific for yourself. Make it as specific as possible based on what you know has to be done. And if you've been on Diamond Zone or any of the trainings the company provides, you know everybody knows what needs to be done. You can't say you don't know. Right? I got to reach people. I got to intrigue them. I got to get them a 2-minute video. I got to follow up. I got to find out if there's an interest. And now here we go. Here's the climb. Same thing every day. So when I say be specific, what is it you need to work on? What is it you need to work on to help your business grow? That's what I'm talking about being specific. Okay? Be exact. Start with bite-sized goals, guys. Being specific allows you to find your little successes because you're setting the specific goal, right? If my goal, right, if I just got out of the hospital, right, and I have my body's totally atrophied, and I go to the gym, and my specific goal was to walk on the treadmill for 5 minutes because that would be something that was unreachable because I was just in the hospital. And I set that treadmill for 5 minutes and I accomplished it. Guess what? I need to celebrate that success. I need to celebrate. I did it, damn it. I set a goal and I did it. You guys got to start doing that and celebrate it. And don't worry about the outcomes. And then the next day, I'm going to do 10 minutes on the treadmill. Well, can we not do the same analogies here? Today, I'm going to touch 5 people. Specific. Do it. Take a break. Give yourself a high five. And then do it again. This is what I'm talking about. Bite-sized goals. Not I'm going to be a president in January. And I want you to understand where that's coming from, guys. Because a lot of people set themselves up for failure just by the goals they're setting for themselves. Okay? So next, measurable. Measurable. Okay, what does this mean? Here we go. How do I do this? Oh, there we go. Okay. Measurable. Make your goal measurable. Whatever you want to achieve, make sure you have a way of measuring when you meet your goal. We just kind of talked about this. Okay? Measurable goal. All the goals that you need to set is your ability to reach people. Maybe the goal is, right, I have to get out there and maybe you're honing your skills on LinkedIn. Great, right? Maybe you're honing your skills on how to post on Facebook. Maybe you're honing your skills on how to go live on Facebook, right? Facebook Live. Maybe it's making your list. And not pre-qualifying your list. But you have to have a way, right, which I just talked about, on how to measure your goals. And normally, guys, it's the number of people you are reaching on a daily basis. That's really what it's all about. Okay, there's really nothing else here because we need people to enter into our business either as a customer or as a new business partner, right? And I love when people say, well, this is a numbers game, Jeff. Yeah, it is a numbers game, absolutely. Okay, achievable, S-M-A. The A is achievable. Is your goal achievable in the allowed time? What steps must you take in order to achieve this goal? Okay, so once again, bite-sized goals equals large-term goals, right? If I do want to become a president, or let's say diamond, I got to reverse engineer it. Is your internet connection? Okay, I think I'm good. Am I good, Joe? Hello? Yes, okay. So is your goal achievable in the allotted time? By the way, my internet provider is coming today. Okay, is your goal achievable in the allowed time? What steps must you take in order to achieve your goal? Okay, what goal though? Is your goal achievable in the allowed time? Well, my goal is to be on Diamond Zone, and the allowed time was an hour. Okay, I was on it. I achieved that goal. Perfect. Well, let me ask you a question. If you don't take the information that you get on a daily basis, was that a good use of your time? It may have got your head right for an hour, but after we leave you, what do? Now, here's where the challenge is. What do you do when no one's looking? And in most cases, no one's ever looking. That's the problem. Remember what I said earlier, right? The reason why we do what we do and we go to work, because somebody's usually looking. Somebody's holding us accountable. Okay, maybe a goal for some of you is to have an accountability partner. How about that one? But be careful what you ask for there. Maybe team up with somebody and hold each other accountable. I know Jenny has Estatis. They hold each other accountable every day. Okay, maybe that's part of it. But you got to get really good. Maybe the accountability partner sort of in the beginning is like training wheels. Right? Remember when you started riding a bike, you had a training wheel? Then what happened? One, you took one off. And your dad would run alongside you. Then you took both off. And now you go, I don't need my training wheels. You got to identify it for you what you need. And don't just look for the answer. Be honest with yourself. If an accountability partner is something, seek one out. Look to your upline. Say, I want to be held accountable. But once again, don't just say it because you don't want to waste that person's time because they really want to hold you accountable. Because all they're going to do is say, okay, what am I holding you accountable to do? You still got to have your plan, right? So whatever that may be, you got to get very clear, okay, for your achievable goals. And you got to put a time frame on it. So let me tell you the time frame we have, okay? Our goal was to go team developer again. We're going to talk about that, okay? Bring in two and help those two get there too. Okay, now we've been team developer 10 times, but we want to do it again. So last week, we brought in two. And we brought in one person left, one person right underneath them. But we want to do it in 7 days. We didn't do it. We didn't do it. We got two and they each got one. But we worked like you know what? We have to do it in 7 days. So we put a time frame. Now, are we still working with those two people? Of course. But you know what our goal is again? Bring in two more. I got to get to team developer in 7 days. I'm just giving you an idea of allowed it time. Now you could take allowed it time to get to team developer, or you could take the allowed it time just to make your 10 phone calls. It doesn't matter. It's your specific goals. And I'm telling you guys, this is a challenge. This is the part that everybody dreads. It's getting into the uncomfortable and the things you're comfortable with, you're really good at. Because if someone asks you the question, how's your new world business going? Oh, it's great. That's great. I'm on these calls every morning, right? It's amazing. I'm getting great personal development. Okay, what have you done? How much money have you made? If someone asked you guys that question, okay, what's your answer? What's your answer? Well, it's you gotta understand, you gotta let people know where you're going, right? If you're not accomplishing your goals, okay, you have to have set one. If I set a goal, could I not share with people what my goal is? Think. Hey, 1 second. Okay. I sit down with Joe and I show Joe a plan to make $50,000 in 2018. Okay? $50,000. So what is that? $4,000 a month? Approximately, right? That's $48,000 a year. That's $1,000 a week, right, Joe? Now, Joe, how much money have you made so far with World? Nothing. See his head? Look it. But do you see Joe on the call every day? Hey, Diamond Zoners. Hey, Diamond Zone family. He feels good, and I'm glad. If that's all he's looking for from World, and we're just his family, I love it. Joe, that's your job. That's your journey. Take this the right way. Okay? But see, I want to take Joe to a different level. So as soon as I put Joe on a business plan, and all of a sudden, now he sees a plan to make $1,000 a week, $4,000 a month, and it's right in front of him. and I reverse engineer it and how he has to, what he's going to have to do to accomplish it. Now somebody asks Joe, "Joe, how's your new business going?" Unbelievable. Do you know, okay, that I'm on a business plan to make 50 grand this year? That's $4,000 a month. And I have my specific plan in order to accomplish it. Now, I don't care who's asking that question. Could I ever doubt the fact that he wants to earn it? Can I doubt the fact that he has a plan? No, I'm just reading Joe. Does he believe that plan? See, once you set a plan, you could speak about it, right? If you bought any other business, you'd have a damn plan. I promise you, you would. You want to know why? Because you probably put a lot of financial wherewithal into that plan. That's why. If you bought a traditional business, would you have a plan? If you put $200,000 into a traditional business, would you not have a plan? And if someone said to you, "How's your new business going?" and you just opened the doors, what are you going to say? "Well, I'm $200,000 in debt. Please buy a lot of stuff." No, you wouldn't say that. You'd say, "Hey, man, I am so excited. Okay, you could see my hours of operation. Look at my inventory. Man, if it's a restaurant, I got the best chef. I got a great menu." Now, you're $500,000 in debt, but you're not telling them that. You know what you're telling them? How great it's going to be. Let me ask you a question. When people ask you how your world's business is, what do you say? I'm kind of getting off track now, but that doesn't matter. It's how my brain works. Okay? What do you say? "Well, you know, it's pretty cool. You know, there's been some issues and some problems, and you know, we've dealt with quite a few things. And hey, you want to get involved?" No, I don't want to get involved. No, I want no part of what you just told me. Are you kidding me? You just told me that there's been problems. You've been telling me that, you know, it's going slow. And now you're trying to engage me and you're trying to recruit me into this mess you're involved in. Then sometimes we wonder, I don't understand. Why does nobody want my opportunity? See, sometimes you guys, you just gotta laugh. And you go, "You know what? That Jeff guy sometimes says some pretty cool things." Because it's true, right? "I just don't understand why so-and-so doesn't call me back." Because you told so-and-so that this place stinks. That's why. What do you think he's not calling you back? Can you imagine running your restaurant that way? "Hey, welcome to our grand opening. How's the food?" "I don't really know. It's my first day. I don't know. The tomatoes don't look quite right. I don't know. You know, the steak, I thought it was going to be fresher, but you know what? It came in a week late. But you know what? Enjoy your service." Would you say that? No, you know what you would say? "Oh my gosh. We have the best drinks. Man, look, check out. This is good. That's good. This is good." Now, let me show you. World Global Network has a menu. You know what your menu is? Your menu is that globe. Remember the globe you all roll your eyes at? That's your menu. Let me show you what's on our menu, everybody. Let me show you what's on our menu. Our menu has something on here. It's owning your own business. This is unbelievable. Let me tell you all the features of owning your own business. Same tax advantages. No employees. No traditional overhead. This is on your menu. Do you guys understand that's your menu that you're offering people in your restaurant? Look what's on our menu, a way to earn extra immediate income by taking advantage of the wearable tech industry. Let me show you over here what's on the menu, a way to be paid what you're worth with no glass ceiling. Look at this feature. Look at this part of the menu. This is the dessert. It's called residual income. This is our dessert. Because without this dessert, you can't retire. That's on our menu. And really, what's really on the menu is a proven system that you could follow. That's your menu that you're offering people. Do you even know what's on your menu? That's my question. This is our achievable goals. This is what I'm talking about. Knowing what you're offering, but being excited about what you're offering. And yeah, here's the challenge. Being excited about something you haven't accomplished yet. There's your biggest challenge. Right? What kind of, what accomplishments did Bill Gates have when he started saying to everybody, there's going to be a computer on every desk in America? And everybody laughed at him. That's when computers were as big as a door. Did it matter? No. Or Steve Jobs, who said, right, there'll be a phone in everybody's hand. These smartphones. No, they saw it first. They knew it was on their menu. They were excited about their goals because they set some. This is the difference, everybody. So that's achievable, realistic. Be realistic about how long it's going to take you to reach your goal. And then step your takes and the steps you're taking to get there. Okay? Well, there's what we leave out. The necessary steps to get there. And I know you guys have seen it thousands and thousands of times, right? With making your list and going through it, you're sick and tired of hearing it. But you got to take those initial steps. You can't hit a home run without a bat in your hand. Can't. Okay, you got to take the necessary steps. And those are the things that you have to get really, really, really realistic with, okay? And then time-stamped. Time-sensitive goals are more likely to be achieved. Where is a loose thought will get piled behind a to-do list that keeps on growing, right? So when you look at this, hang on. Let me just go back up. Hang on. I could do this. Where'd it go? Oh, there we go. No. Anyway. All right. So anyway, that's when I say time-stamped, okay, it's a to-do list, guys, of what you make sure you do on a daily basis. Now, I go back to what I always say, okay, you got to have your schedule. Got to have a schedule. Whatever you're going to put forth, okay, you got to write it down. You got to schedule these events every day. You got to schedule you're practicing your presentation. You got to schedule making your list. You got to schedule the time you're going to make calls. You're going to schedule your follow-up. This is a business. It really is. And it's a craft you have to really get good at. And you got to create your hypnotic rhythm with it. Until you create your hypnotic rhythm, this is going to be very difficult to get traction. That's the key to our business, is traction. And man, you got to persevere through you got to persevere through storms. And it's hard sometimes. I get it. Okay? But you know when it gets hard? When you commit to your goals. That's when it really gets hard. Why? Because when you commit to your goals, you're taking action steps. When you're taking action steps, means you're dealing with people. And when you're dealing with people, you're dealing with their problems. And it's real simple. The more problems you help solve, the more money you earn. Our business is all about problems. You know that, right? Because every person has a problem they want to solve. They're looking to you because they chose from your menu what part they want. I want that residual income thing because I've been working 40 years. Okay, that person just told you their problem and you told them we can help you over here. Right? So now they're looking to you and go, okay, And now that's the biggest problem of the business. If we could just eliminate the people part of this, we'd all be rich. People make me nuts. Okay. But see, that's when you have to start to enjoy the journey. I've learned, and it's taken me years and years to enjoy the journey. Man, there's things that you that go on that you guys never see, but you know what? Whenever I'm in front of people, okay, I gotta let them know in a very upfront way that this is gonna take effort. And then you add to it all the stuff, right, that maybe not is not perfect. Then you're really challenged. And I'm just being straight with you. Some of you got involved because we're a startup. And I always say, be careful what you ask for. Now we're going into 2018. We're going into 2018 and we're looking at, okay, a year that will dwarf what happened in 2017. But what I want to do is I want to take some people with us. That's what I want. I just love the fact, you know what gets me excited? Reaching another person who says, you know what, damn it, I'm taking this journey. That's what really gets me excited. I'm taking this journey. I'm doing it. I don't care what happens. I'm going to go all in. Now, when I say all in, because I hate that word because it's somebody else's word, okay? When I say you're going to commit to it, you're going to commit to it. You're going to commit to getting better every day. There's nothing more rewarding than that. The outcome has nothing to do with that. It's making that decision first. And then holding yourself, okay, every day holding yourself and getting better every day. If you looked at 2017, you say, you know what? This is what I got out of 2017. Look at the positive. Was there a positive? Well, let me give you one positive. You made the decision. You made a decision to change. That was positive. Let's say that's all that happened. You should still celebrate that. Because how many people in 2017 complained about their situation but didn't even make the decision to change? Now, maybe 2018 is I'm going to do something with this decision that I changed. That's just your journey. So what? But have a journey. That's all I'm saying. Have a purpose. Take what you got and do something with it. I mean, I know without a doubt, if everybody on this call was making 500 a week, you'd be ecstatic. Where's my buddy Joe? Sitting here every day. I get it. I'm not beating up on Joe. I think it takes courage for Joe to say, hey, I've been on here every day. I haven't done anything. I've earned no money. Okay, Joe, when's the time? When is your time? When are you going to make that decision? But what if Joe just likes to hang out with all of us? That's okay. That's okay. I still love Joe. My goal is I just want to keep in Joe long enough. Maybe Joe will lead me to somebody. That's how I look at people just hanging out. And that's okay. This is not a beat-up session. No one's your boss. But I just want you to be realistic with your goals. Don't say it's not working if you haven't done any of these things. And if you're saying, well, I'm waiting for everything to be perfect. Well, there's a lot of people making a lot of money with things not perfect. So you could use whatever excuse you want. The excuses will always be there. In fact, I'm going to do that training next week. I'm going to put on all the 5,000 excuses people have. There's never going to be a shortage of excuses. But guys, I'll tell you right now, this right now, this right here, we're at a crossroads. All of us are. And I'm telling you what's going to happen in 2018. I see it. I want you to see it. I want you to be sold on it. And don't let, right, whatever you have going on, take those steps and get uncomfortable. Look at your strengths, highlight your weaknesses, work on the weaknesses. And I gave you a couple of tips today, maybe to help you find an accountability partner. Maybe that's one of them. But don't just say, okay, I'm going to find an accountability partner, okay, if you don't want to be held accountable. Don't just because that makes you feel good. Take your necessary steps, whatever they are, okay? And then here's a good first goal, okay? And I'm going to shut up. This is the challenge I have for everybody. This is a very realistic first goal. Go team developer again. Or maybe go team developer for the first time. How about that one? Okay. Go team developer. How do you get to team developer? You got to get your first two. Right? Well, how do I get two? I got to talk to what? What's your closing percentage? You don't know that? Okay, let's just put a number to it. Let's put 100. Would you talk to 100 to set yourself up to get your first two to start the ball rolling? It's probably not going to be 100, by the way. Okay, if your closing percentage was 10%, okay, what's 10% of 20? Is that 2, right? Am I right? Yeah, I think that's right. Okay, so 20 people. Go team developer. And then help them get their 2. Before the end of the year, there's a good first goal. What would we have, 2 weeks? So I'm not saying 7 days. I'm not saying 30 days. Let's do it in 2 weeks. If you put a laser focus, and I said to you, listen, if you accomplish this, okay, you're going to have $10,000 wired into your account. Would you do it? Let me ask you a question. If you went team developer, what do you think that could mean to you in the future? Think it could be worth more than $10,000? You know our first team developer that we brought in? Okay, we made $250,000 last year. Do you know that first team developer we brought in was $40,000 of that? In other words, the first two who got their two, those six people equaled $40,000 of our income last year. That's what a team developer was worth. One. And you just said, I'll take the 10,000. No. You keep your 10,000. What would six new people mean to your business? I want you guys to think. Forget about it. Just it's the bodies. Go out there and get two and teach those two how to get two. Now, what if the first two don't get their two? You got to add two more. Just like I'm doing this week. We got to get two more. I'm still going to work with the other ones, but my goal is to do it in 7 days. The first one will do it in 30 days, but that wasn't my goal. My goal was 7 days to get them there. And I'm just putting out a challenge. 2 weeks, get to team developer again. With the special that we have, $200 off. Okay? Or whatever. I'm just setting a goal for you. Don't have to take mine. Maybe your goal is what? I'm going to sell 6 helos. Okay, then sell it, whatever yours is. But I'm assuming you all want to build. Well, if my assumption is right, you got to go team developer again. I'm going to say it again. That first team developer we brought in equaled $40,000 of our income. One team developer. So you think there's a value to bringing bodies into your company? And that's the challenge. So be specific, guys, okay, in your goals. Be honest with yourself. Just have a come to Jesus meeting. I shouldn't say that, but you know, whatever your religion is, come to Buddha meeting, come to whoever meeting that you want to have, okay, and just be honest with yourself. Just be completely honest. What am I doing? Just say that. What am I doing? What do I want to do? And do I really want to do it? There's no right or wrong answer. It's your answer. But I will say this. You have an unbelievable opportunity in front of you. And I believe in you more than you believe in you. And that's the problem. You got to get to a point where you believe in you. And the only way to do that is to set goals and go, you know what, damn it? I did it. I believed it. I believed it and I did it. And then you'll do it again. But until you do that, you'll never have the belief. Because what do you believe it in? You're believing that you're doing nothing. That's all. That's where you get the belief. And then when you get the belief, now when you bring a new person in, you can share how you got your belief. And guess what? That's how you duplicate. That's when you become this duplication force. Because you know how you got your belief. That's everything. Because what happens with belief? Confidence. Problem is, a lot of you don't have the confidence yet because you haven't sat down and just done some very simple things. That's all. That's the good news. If all of you have been busting your butt, then I'd say, you know what? Okay, but I know that's not the fact. I know that's not the fact. And if you have, give me a call and let's really go through what busting your butt meant. Let's really break it down. But be careful what you ask for. If you have a conversation with me, I'm going to ask you some specific questions. You're saying you're busting your butt? Okay, let's go through it. So, love you guys. Remember today, where are they all at? Hi. There's everybody. Hey, Joe, you know I was just playing with you, brother, right? We're just going back and forth. All right, Joe's good. Joe's fine. Okay. Where is everybody else? Okay, everybody. Hey, Terry. Terry Bernier's on. There's the Strohs, Elena. You know, we actually had more people on Diamond Zone than they had on the weekly call last week. Okay. You guys are great. I love you guys. All right, guys, talk to you soon. 12 o'clock, 6 o'clock. Today, right? 12 o'clock? What time is it? Okay, 7:51. All right, guys, I'm out. This has been recorded. Bye. Ramble, Jeff. Ramble, ramble, ramble.